we are going to hear from Triple H for the very first time since the assault by Brock Lesnar. We'll hear from Triple H live next week on Monday Night Raw. Now, we're also being told that, well, the WWE has extended an invitation to Brock Lesnar to be a part of the show here tonight.
He was supposed to be here tonight.
But he declined, and instead, from what we're being told, well, he sent his legal representatives to get us updated on his situation. Representation. That man is the man who represents Brock Lesnar's career. Many of you know him. That is Paul Heyman, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Paul Heyman. And I am here tonight as the representative for Brock Lesnar. The single most dominant, the single most decorated, the single most destructive athlete in the history of WWE, but a man, ladies and gentlemen, that has been booed and maligned and mistreated and underappreciated by the WWE audience since day one. Just like that. And that especially holds true for corporate management. Oh, come on. Today's WWE is so much different than it was 10 years ago when I first represented Brock Lesnar. Today's WWE it's so image conscious. But despite that fact, it was the executive vice president of talent relations and the general manager for both Raw and SmackDown, John Laurinaitis, who signed Brock to a legitimate contract. Now, admittedly, Brock Lesnar, subsequent to that contract, made a few reasonable verbal demands which were agreed to on live television, which makes every single one of you a party to that agreement. Ladies and gentlemen, Brock Lesnar feels betrayed. Betrayed by the WWE Universe. And Brock Lesnar should not have to feel that way. Because Brock Lesnar is the only man in history to hold the NCAA Division I Heavyweight Wrestling Championship, the undisputed WWE Heavyweight Championship, and the undisputed UFC Heavyweight Championship of the world. And yet, above all else, I know, and you should know, that Brock Lesnar is an honest man. Brock Lesnar told you he was going to be an ass-kicking machine, and Brock Lesnar was an ass-kicking machine. Brock Lesnar told you he was going to hurt people, and Brock Lesnar hurt people. But instead of me standing out here and running down Brock Lesnar's accolades, I got one better for you. Tonight, Brock Lesnar asked me to personally come here and read to you his statement, the official statement of Brock Lesnar to you. And I quote, "I came back to bring legitimacy to WWE, That's exactly what I did. And how was I rewarded? With the same corporate BS and politics that led me to leave 8 years ago. I don't regret what I did to John Cena. I embarrassed him. Another guy I embarrassed was Triple H. He's always been jealous of me. Triple H lasted nearly 1 hour in a cell with The Undertaker, but he couldn't last 1 minute in a fight with me. Triple H tried to push his weight around because now he has an office job. I had an agreement with the company and he broke it, so I broke his arm. I don't care about Triple H. I don't care about you people. And I don't care about the corporate suits at WWE because I, Brock Lesnar, am never coming back. Because I, Brock Lesnar, quit.
Brock Lesnar's comeback in the WWE lasted all of about a month.
Yeah, I don't know what to say about that. I thought it was a big enough show.